Don't make hard work of it. Don't make a chore of this. It's a game. It's a game of alignment. It's a game of alignment. It's a game of alignment.
What do you do?
I play the game of alignment.
What does that mean?
Well, I'm a creator, and I use all of the universal forces to my advantage.
What does that mean?
Well, there's this stream that is flowing directly toward everything I want.
How do you get in?
Well, sometimes you tiptoe in and it's moving so fast it just takes you. Sometimes you get in and it's moving so slow you wonder if it's going to go at all. But you just have to trust. 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 That things are working out for you. This is what you're telling to others for watching this successful being that you are. I stop nitpicking over things that don't matter. I stop beating up on myself unnecessarily. I stop making work of things that aren't work. Start utilizing the leverage of the energy that creates worlds to my advantage. Start listening more for my inner voice. Start being aware more of how I feel and caring about it. I started recognizing when I don't feel good that if I try a little bit, I can release the thought that is at the root of my not feeling good.
How do you do that?
Well, I usually just quiet my mind and don't think about it at all.
How do you do that?
We'll have a meditation process.
What's that like?
Well, I just focus on things that are really general, like the dripping of a faucet or the sound in the air conditioner, or I watch something that's mesmerizing.
How do you do that?
Well, sometimes it's more difficult than others, but I have a strong motive for doing it.
What's your motive for doing it?
Well, I want to feel better. It's everything. Feeling better is everything. When I feel better, I'm non-resistant.
Well, so what? You're non-resistant. What does that mean?
Well, it means now I easily go with the stream in the direction of everything that I want. And when I get into that current and I stop paddling against it, it takes me where I want to go.
How do you know the stream is going to take you where you want to go?
Because I've been there many times. 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 I know that when I chill and allow, the well-being is mine. Things are always working out for me.
How can things always be working out for you?
They are. Things are always working out for all of us if we allow it.
How do you know whether you're allowing it or not?
By the way you feel.
What do you do? How do you know you're not allowing it?
Don't feel good.
What do? When you're not allowing it?
Meditate. It's the path of least resistance to what I want. It's proven itself to me over and over and over again. I can control the way I feel because I can control the direction of my mind. And since I can control the direction of my thoughts, then I can control my vibrational point of attraction. And since I can control my vibrational point of attraction, then I can control everything that comes to me. It's really worth chilling. It's really worth getting a handle on this. I know these things to be true. I am the creator of my own reality. And I offer a vibration that everything responds to. And I can tell what vibration I'm offering by the things that are coming to me. and by the way I feel. And sometimes I wait till they get there before I figure it out, and sometimes I feel him coming. But in any case, I'm always aware of whether I'm on my path or off my path.
On what path? Off of what path? What path? What path?
The path of my unfolding. The path of my becoming. The path of my eternal evolution. The path of my eternal beingness. The path of my goodness. The path of my wholeness. The path where the source and I join together in concert for the joy of this moment in time that we are perceiving.
What's that moment in time like?
Well, sometimes it feels outrageously good. And that means to me that my point of view and the point of view of my source are identical. I can feel when I'm in sync with the source within me.
How do you know that?
By the way I feel. By the love I feel. By the passion I feel. By the appreciation I feel.
How'd you find that?
I meditated my way into it. I quieted my mind enough that I no longer did that thing I did that muted it or blocked it. I tuned myself to the frequency of my highest good, and now my highest good rendezvous with me everywhere I go. Beautiful thing, isn't it? So if we were standing in your physical shoes, the things that we would have gotten that we feel that we could go home and apply are these. I can control the way I feel regardless of what's going on, and I seek to do that because the way I feel is everything. My emotions let me know my relationship with everything that I want. And when I control my emotion, I control my relationship with everything that I want. There is no other factor that exists anywhere in my time-space reality or elsewhere that affects the way things come to me or don't. I am singularly responsible and singularly in control of everything that happens in my experience. I have the ability to look at what is in a way that doesn't please me, or I have the ability to look at what is in a way that does please me. Whether I'm focused, past, present, or future, I'm doing it all right now. I'm doing it all right now. And my relationship with the opinion of my source on those same subjects is active within me right now and giving me feedback. When I feel exhilaration, I am in complete harmony with the opinion of my source. And the opinion of my source is what? What is the opinion of my source? What is it the source is really reaching for with me? What does source most want relative to me? Source wants me to be the recipient of everything that I've been asking for. And source is so determined that I will have that success, that source never strays from an understanding or from a focus upon exactly what I am wanting. So much so that my emotion lets me know when someone has strayed. And every single time, it's me. And every single time, it's me. And I know what to do about it now. Go general. Go general. Go general. The more specific I get, the more I stray. The more general I get, the more I come back into alignment. So I'm going to come into alignment and then I'll stray a little. And then I'll come into alignment and I'll spray a little. Until I have tuned my frequency to the frequency of Source, to the opinion of Source, to the knowing of Source, to the expectation of Source, on everything that is important to me. And when I achieve a chronic, consistent expectation that matches the expectation that Source holds for me on the subjects that matter to me, now the grid fills in, the grid fills in, the grid fills in, the grid fills in, and people who are watching me are watching in amazement. Who are you? They say. How is it that you barely express your desire for something and someone walks up with you to a very clear-cut path for the receiving of it? And you say, I am the keeper of my promise to the Source within me. I said, I'll go forth and sift and sort, and I will carve out lanes of expansion for all of us. And the Source within me said, and I will follow the track of your desire, and I will hold to the frequency of that, and I will send a signal that is so bright about that that you can't miss it. Because you will always feel emotion around something that matters to you. The guidance will always be there. Strong emotion indicates it really matters. Strong negative emotion means I'm off the track. Strong positive emotion means I'm on the track. We think your guidance system is perfect. And we think you have been playing it out in a perfect way. We think that the world that is before you is a very bright world. We think the world that is here right now is just exactly right. We think that you are the creator of your own experience. And we think that right now, this very moment, you know that in a more vivid way than you've ever known it before. The second thing that we think that you've gathered from this is that at least it's what we would have wanted to take away from it if we were standing in your physical shoes. Contrast, every bit of it, is a good thing. And when I stand in a place that didn't turn out the way I thought it was going to, or even I thought maybe it should have, that rather than beating up on myself about the incompletion of this desire, instead, I'm going to take this contrast as the exact thing that it is. More information for meaningful expansion. Because it means there's something in my vortex that this new contrast is going to help me to sort out. You're the creator of your experience. You are not a regurgitator. You're not a puppet on a string. You are the creator of your experience. Do you get that? And don't you want the information with which to create? And don't you like the support that we all provide once you've carved it out? Don't you really like it that there's someone that says, well, you've forgotten, but you really, really want this. And you've forgotten this, but you really, really want this too. And you might have forgotten about that, but in the third grade, you decided that you really, really wanted that. And you really, really want this, and you want this, and you want this, and you want this, and it's all here. And it all is in harmony with itself. In other words, there's nothing that's in your vortex that's out of character or out of vibrational alignment with everything else. We've enjoyed this interaction immensely. And it is our continuing promise to you that we will stand fully informed and fully aware in your vortex, understanding where you are in direct relationship with every single thing that you want, speaking loudly with everything that we have, but it's a vibrational voice that you have to feel for. And we are confident that you have the tools with which to do that. There's great love here for you, and we remain effortlessly in the vortex.